Yes, here we are going to see the lesson communication system. First of all, let's know what is communication. Communication nothing but it is the act of transmission of information. When we are talking between from other person, we are transmitting the information to him. Means we are communicating with him. Means communication nothing but it is the act of transmission of information. Yes. Now every communication system has three essential parts. Three important parts. What are the three important parts of every communication system? See, now this is the communication system which is in the dotted box. This is the communication system. This communication system having the three essential parts. The three essential parts are transmitter, second one is channel, and third one is the receiver. Let us try to understand what are transmitter, channel, and receiver. Transmitter is the device. This receives the information from the source of information. For example, let us consider the transmission of the radio programs. In radio station, someone singing the some a song. The song has to be transmitted. First of all, the person sings the song in a microphone so that information is produced. That information signals are given to, message signals are given to the transmitter. Then what is the functioning of transmitter here? This transmitter converts message signals into suitable form for the transmission. Means directly we cannot transmit the message signals. Means when a person sings, the voice signals cannot be transmitted to long distances directly. Now we need a device. That device is the transmitter. The transmitter transmits message signals. Means the transmitter converts message signals into suitable form for transmission. For transmission, the message signals has to be converted into some other form. That can be done by the device transmitter. Transmitter converts message signals into suitable form for the transmission. Now at the output of transmitter, we get transmitted signals. Now these transmitted signals propagating through the channel. Now first of all, what is channel? Channel is the physical medium that connects a transmitter and a receiver. Between transmitter and receiver, channel is the physical medium. Channel is nothing but it may be wires means cables, or wireless. Channel may be wires or wireless. For example, let us take a mobile communication. In mobile communication, channel is a wireless space. In a landline communication, the channel is the wires. Like this, channel is the physical medium that connects the transmitter and a receiver. Now at the output of the channel, the receiver receives the signals. Now what is the functioning of a receiver? Here the receiver receives the signals from the channel. Whenever the signals propagating through the channel, the signals may be retarded. Means some noise is added to the signals. What is meant by noise here? Noise nothing but these are the unwanted signals which are added to the information signals that tend to disturb the transmission of information signals. Okay, now here the receiver receives the distorted signals. From the distorted signals, the receiver reconstructs the original signal. After reconstructing the original signal, this the original message signal is sent to the user of information. We are the user of informations. Means when we are listening the some music or a song in a radio, now we are the user of information. Like this, in every communication system, there are three essential parts, transmitter, channel, and receiver. Okay, but here the communication is of two types. There are two basic modes of communication. One is the point-to-point communication. The first type of communication is the point-to-point communication. In point-to-point communication, for every receiver, there is only one transmitter. In point-to-point communication, the point-to-point communication takes place over a link between the transmitter and receiver, like in landline communication. For example, we are talking with our friend in landline phone. We are the transmitter, your friend will be the receiver, like we can say. Means for every receiver, there is only one transmitter in case of point-to-point communication. In point-to-point communication, only one receiver for one transmitter. And in a second type of communication, that is called broadcast communication. In second type of communication is the broadcast communication. In broadcast communication, for one transmitter there are number of receivers. For example, radio programs, television programs, and internet communication. In all these communications, there are so many number of receivers for one transmitter. Like this, there are two basic modes of communication systems. The first one is point-to-point communication. In point-to-point communication, for one transmitter, one receiver is there. In broadcast communication, for one transmitter, there are number of receivers. Now, while we are going to understand the communication system, we should know some terms which we use regularly, which we use frequently in this lesson. Now, first of all, let's know about transducer.